Yep. Yeah, boy, got the Sony Alpha 6300 for $300. How cool is that? Bro, I literally got the body, the cage, three batteries, where one was the original Sony battery, a 64 gig SD card, and a charger for $300. What a freaking deal, right? All right, listen. Nowadays, it feels like almost every single filmmaker is chasing the brand new Sony A7S III, right? Which costs like 3,500 or something, and with the new SD cards, batteries, full frame lenses, whoo! With this video, I want to show you that you don't necessarily need to spend thousands of dollars to get great results. For just $300, I'm gonna show you what this camera is capable of, because many of you already know that I'm a Sony Alpha 6500 shooter, and this camera, Sony Alpha 6300, which I got for $300, is pretty much the same thing. The only differences are pretty much the buffer is a bit slower and it doesn't have IBIS, but I mean, Sony's IBIS has never really been that impressive, so meh. But yeah, I'm just gonna be showing you some dope footage. Just gonna walk around the town a little bit, have a little bit of fun, and give you my honest opinion about this camera and the reason why I totally still recommend this in 2020.
My God, this mountain.
All right, let's talk about the Sony Alpha 6300 a little bit. Let's start talking about the autofocus. It's amazing, that's all I gotta say. It's literally the same as Sony Alpha 6500. If you're a vlogger, you're gonna be very happy about it. If you film commercial work, you're gonna be very happy about it. If you shoot events and weddings, you're gonna be extremely happy about it. It does the job, and it does the job very well. All right, dynamic range, same as on the Alpha 6500. Really, really good. Even though it's not 10-bit, on 8-bit you can still get really, really good colors. I mean, you saw some of the examples. I probably look so dramatic with all the leaves falling right now. All right, the color science, it's not great, but with a little bit of post-production, you can make it look amazing. It's probably not gonna be one of those cameras which is gonna look amazing straight out of the camera. You will need to do little tweaks here and there, but if you do them, it's gonna look nice. I'm gonna name you two main reasons why this is a really, really good deal. First of all, it's such a small camera. It's so tiny. As you guys know, portability and mobility are one of the most important factors I take into consideration when grabbing a new tool. And this is exactly why I grabbed a Sony Alpha 6300, because it's small, it's portable, it's amazing. I love it. But now let's talk about one of the main reasons why you should actually grab this kind of a camera. Look, a couple of years ago, people said like, oh, if you will grab a Sony, the lenses will be super expensive and it's just not worth it. Just go with Canon, you know, the lenses are super cheap. Well, I don't think that's the case anymore nowadays, because there are so many great options out there. For example, look, let's say your budget was €1,000, right? And let's say you found also this kind of a similar deal online. You just got a Sony Alpha 6300 for like $300 with the memory card and with like two or three batteries, right? Let's say you still have $700 and you need a bunch of lenses, right? This is what I would recommend. If you need a wide angle lens, you should definitely grab the Samyang 12mm 2.0 lens, because it costs only $200. Legit, I saw an advertisement the other day where it cost only $200. And let's say you also want to do some portrait shots, right? You should grab either the Sigma 30 or Sigma 50 6mm, because both lenses cost around $300 to $350 and they're both just so good. Maybe you want an 85mm. Well, the Sony 85mm costs around $400, so you're still within your budget. So for $1,000, you could basically, you're in business. You have all you will ever need, well, except for a drone and gimbal and lights and audio, but I mean, you can already start shooting client work with that equipment. That's amazing. A camera body, which shoots 4K up to 30 frames per second, 1080p, 120 frames per second with sound. It has S-Log 2, it has great autofocus. I mean, bro, for $300, are you kidding me? 7 years ago, I worked my ass off for a year as a student just to get Nikon D5200, which I bought for 700 euros. And man, I was so happy to see that that camera was recording 60 frames per second in 720p. And now for $300, you get this, like what the hell? Sometimes it's not worth it to look at the latest and greatest, especially with all these crazy cameras coming out. People are like crazy on them and they're selling their old gear, and you can get some really good deals now. Especially like, oh man, I bet people are gonna be selling their Sony a7 III's like crazy, and you're gonna be able to maybe get a body for like 1K, which is just unbelievable. Anyway, thank you so much guys for watching this video. Hopefully you got something out of it, and hopefully I will make you save some money. So yeah. Have a nice day, and you know the drill. Peace out.